the first thing you have to think about is how to find the data. The physical layer, where we store all of your data, imagine that in the on-premises environment. An on-premises environment, an IT admin or operator knows exactly who's on what disk drive, where that disk drive is, where that computer is. They can walk down the hallway, they can open the door, go and get that drive, take it out, they have the data. Now in the online system, first of all, nobody has access to the physical data. The only people who have access are the folks that are doing maintenance on the servers. Now they have themselves absolutely no ability to go find out who lives on what partition, what disk, because they're not the administrators in the environment. So let's say that they did want to go pull a drive. Let's speculate. Let's say they went and pulled a drive out of the environment. They go to a server, pull the drive out. As soon as they pull it out, no data available to them, because we have taken techniques like BitLocker to make sure that drive is completely useless as soon as it's pulled out of the environment. Now, that's the extreme case. In a regular maintenance case, we are destroying drives as we send them out to our manufacturer. But assume that if you were to have physical access, you would have no idea whose disk drive you just pulled, whose data you just pulled, even if you were able to open that disk drive up. You cannot find the data. It's like finding a needle in the haystack. The next thing you should think about is targeting the data. Let's say we move past the physical layer into the logical layer. Let's say that you were able to find yourself an avenue to get on a server where this data lived. Now in this avenue, what we have done is we have made sure that nobody is able to execute any code that is not known to us. So let's say you got onto a server and you wanted to go find some malicious code that lived out in the internet. You opened up the browser. Well, you can't open up the browser. It's not allowed to go get random pieces of data from outside our environment onto these servers. Now, you could be clever. We totally understand that there are a lot of clever people out there. Clever malicious people out there. Let's say that somehow you figured out how to get a browser-like entity going on the server, and you opened up that process, and you got some piece of code, and you put it on our servers. That piece of code won't run, because what we do is we make sure that only known processes are whitelisted, such that only those will run. It's not just about the name. We will thumbprint, fingerprint, techniques like AppLocker to make sure that even if you were to get onto one of our servers, you could not target the data. You would not be able to run a browser to go get things from the internet. If you were to somehow get things from the internet, somehow figure out a way to get code running on that server, it would not run. So it is very, very hard for you as a malicious person in our environment to actually run code on our servers and target the data. Then, of course, there's the user layer. The user layer is interesting because naturally when you think about data security, you always think about the IT admin or the services provider, because you feel they have the data, they should do something about the sanctity of that data. And we absolutely do. That's like the 80% case. Even the 80% case where we've taken care of the logical layer, the physical layer, all the things I talked about, there's still the opportunity for an end user in your organization to accidentally or maliciously send information outside of that organization. And what we do is we make sure that you have the controls built into Office 365 that allow you to lock down at the file and item level. You can make sure that an email is only read by a certain subset of your individuals in your organization. You can make sure that they're never going to forward it outside of their organization. You can make sure with RMS and DLP that critical information stays in your hands and even ages out over time, such that the opportunity of or the window of opportunity for leaking that information is very, very short or it doesn't exist at all. And of course, our job is never done. We ourselves are testing our own boundaries. We have a red team and a blue team, one contracting the other. A red team goes and actively, sneakily, you know, using all the techniques that are open, available in the wide internet, try and break into our service regularly. And the blue team tries to stop them. Now, using this kind of rigor and discipline, we make sure that we are testing ourselves continuously. Topmost in our priority list, we are making sure that we are stopping every exploit and filling every hole that we find.